What's up, YouTube? So today I want to show you guys a review of performance with iOS 10 on an iPhone 5. This is based on beta 1, so, you know, give it some slack. It is a beta. But I'm just performing a boot up here. I don't have a timer, but I'm about 30 seconds into the boot. So we'll see how long it takes, if it takes a long time. So we're about 50 seconds there to boot up, and we'll just enter in the passcode and kind of get a feel of, there's a bit of lag there. So I'm just doing this just to show you guys. This is actually a glitch that I've been able to replicate quite a bit. If you scroll back and forth, you'll just lose all your icons, and then you get them back just by swiping. And yeah, so here we go. Most of the widgets have loaded up now. We'll launch some apps. So I've had a few issues with the App Store. It sometimes loads, sometimes doesn't load. Kind of like what it's doing here, where it stops loading and then sometimes it'll go through. The camera app opens up pretty quick. I did notice that when I first installed the beta, it just seems to be on really fast. And once you get a bunch of apps going, it does glitch out a bit, but it is beta 1, so as you can see there, weather failed to load. Sorry, this is on an Apple ID, so I want to make sure I don't open something I didn't want to open. I will be doing a review of the new health kit, so make sure you guys check back for that. But we've got a bunch of applications running now, so you can kind of see there just going in and out, the animation. I noticed the control center can be, as you've seen there, and then the notification center. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna close all these apps. You can see there, bounce around. I'm gonna run a Geekbench. Now this did work when I ran it the one time and I did save my benchmark, but it may crash because it did crash on me a couple times. But we'll find out here. Alright, so the scores are pretty consistent from what I've been getting. Very similar to iOS 9 in terms of performance. Seems to lack a little bit on the multi-core score. Usually it's around 1300. But there you guys go. That is the performance on the iPhone 5. Would I recommend it? Probably not. I would wait for a few betas so they get a few things worked out. I did notice it almost seems like a networking condition profile was left on. There's a real lag in the download speed with the device. Now that could be just this device or my network, or it could be something, like I was saying, with a networking conditioning profile. Because you see there, it always drops. It gets a good download speed at first, and then it really loses it. And I have quite a bit more than what it's actually downloading at. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you like this video. Subscribe to the channel for more. And we'll see you again next time. Cheers.